So just waiting for some people to join in because we've just logged in. So it will take a bit of a time for people to know that we are back.
Yeah, no problem. So when you give a hint, we know that it is starting.
But we are already on Facebook. We are live. All of us are live. So finally, Rachna call. Finally, thank you for all your patience. You Utsa family are the best ever because they have just been waiting for the connectivity and connections and everything. So I'm so happy everybody is just thronging. All of a sudden, everybody's coming. Bah, 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 bah. So nice.
No, first it was 8 o'clock, so everybody was thinking that it will start 8 o'clock.
Yeah, and but then we wanted to take you straight on to Facebook because we changed the format and everything. Yeah, so yeah. Just wanted everybody to come. Yeah, so first of all, Sujata ji, bahut bahut pranam aapko. And welcome to the 121st consecutive episode of Utsaha hashtag spreading happiness. It is the 121st day that we are continuing to spread happiness through music and dance. And it is towards serving towards people because to make people happy, to make people, while we are all under lockdown and we are at homes and doctors and governments, everybody is doing their bit to serve humanity, to save lives. I think doctors are next to God in these times. They've done incredible work they're doing. So I just thought that we should do something to serve through music so that while people are at home, the magic, the strength, the power of our music and dance can heal. It works. It makes you calm. It makes you happy. It makes you positive. And everything that is good in this world, it works on your nervous system. So basically, it started with that. And today, I am so privileged to be talking to you. You are such a great maestro. And I've been your fan for so long. And you have... you're such an amazing achiever of your dance form. And here we have one student of Odissi dance, Adrija, who's from Kolkata. And since yesterday I announced your name, she has been jumping in our house. I could actually visualize because the kind of comments she was writing. So I just thought that, you know, we should bring her on just for first 5 minutes so that she can have your darshan. And she is learning Odissi. And her name is Adrija Devnath. And Adrija, I first give you the opportunity to talk to your idol, your goddess. You've been saying you look up to her for everything. So you can have a word, you can ask her a question or two about Odissi and then I will continue and then you can watch us talk. Yeah. Put your mic on.
Yeah. Okay. I don't have any words to thank you. Pranam to both of you. I cannot believe that I'm in the same screen with Durga ma'am and Sujata ma'am. I just don't know what to say. I seriously don't know what to say to Sujata ma'am. I've been,
Say. Keep continue. We understand your feel.
Oh my God.
Adrija, say. People are going to see you.
Yeah, I'm sorry. It's
very good feeling. It's, you know, your tears are actually expressing your emotions from within. Yes. And I'm happy that because of Utsaha, you're getting to talk to her, see her, and talk to her directly. I'm happy that this platform is helping you to express to your idol, to your goddess.
Yes, I cannot really thank you enough. So actually, we are from a very small town called Alipurduar in North Bengal. So the opportunities there were very limited. And in spite of that, my parents always tried very hard to... you know, give me the correct guidance. And so way back in 2009, online shopping was not even a thing. And my mom sat in a cyber cafe and ordered this. So this CD another CD from Doordarshan archive in which there was Guru Keluchan Mahapatra's dance and Sangjukta Panigrahi ma'am's dance. So I have been watching this from, I don't know, years. And the way you perform only Mangalacharan, I was completely blown away. I have never, I don't know if I can ever even think of achieving that kind of perfection on stage. Whenever in the entire video, wherever you pause, it will always be perfect. Nothing will be out of place. The entire posture, body expressions, everything, nothing will be out of, I don't know how you do that. And amazing, amazing. And I keep watching your interviews, even in Odia. I have now started understanding Odia also a bit by seeing your interviews and everything. So it is amazing. And ma'am, I got to do an online workshop thanks to the lockdown with Guruji in the July one. You came to greet us one day wearing a red sari, and then also I was shouting, ma'am, I'm your biggest fan.
Thank you so much. I could understand what is your feelings, but everything only happens because of Guru's blessings. Okay. I'm fortunate to have Guruji in my life, so that's why I could do this and I could generate that to you, that today when I see you, the happiness, the, you know, like whatever the emotion comes from your heart, it reaches to me, and I feel lucky and I feel fortunate that at least my art could serve, give you that much happiness. And I'm sure one day we will meet, because the world is very small. And never think that Alipur is a small town, because I belong to a small town called Balasore. So, you know, small town with having a big heart and coming to the art, it's a connection of God. And I'm sure you will definitely get some opportunity to come to me, come to our school and learn something. Okay?
Thank you so, so much. Both of you. I really don't know what to say. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I'm glad. I'm so happy to see that smile, Adrija. Keep it going. I love this, the way you love her so, with so much of your heart, means how much you love the art within her. And this is the next generation India has. And I'm so happy to see now, you know, that our next generation loves our art form so much. So thank you, Adrija. And now I will have a dialogue with her, and you can keep posting your questions. So it will help me. Okay. So okay. I'll read your questions and I'll ask her that. All the best. Yeah. God bless. And keep working hard. You know, it's Guru's blessings, and she has worked very hard to achieve what she has. That she's not telling you, but I'm telling you. Bye. Bye. Thank you, Adrija. Bye. Lots of love. Big hug.
Yes. Pranam to both of you. Thank you.
Jitero. Jitero. Sujata ji, you have inspired millions. Millions. I mean, I know for a fact that everybody of who's an aspiring dancer looks up to you. They worship you. They really, want to be like you, and you have achieved that which so many people over generations hope to achieve, that one day I become a performing artist, I become something that will leave a legacy. But I want to know, how did the whole process start? When was it that you really started learning, and how did it really, how it must have been full of hard work. Please tell people that you worked hard. Don't tell them it's that easy. Blessings. Please.
First of all, thank you, Durga. I mean, I'm extremely happy that from our family to your family, we have a great bondage from Guruji and Panditji. So today when we are speaking in the place of dance class, I feel that same connection that we are two family who has a great bonding.
Absolutely.
So God has given us the chance, at least even in this time also, we are together.
Yeah.
And we will be happy, and whatever the intention we have, definitely we will fulfill to our viewers and to everyone in the world. First of all, I want to make it very short because we don't have so much of time, but you know, life journey in dance and sadhana, the word sadhana cannot be said within an hour. Because it's a journey, life journey. But still I would like to say that from beginning to till now, I do achieve something by my hard work, sincerity, and Guru Bhakti.
Oh.
There is two main things, which is sacrifice, tyaga, and sadhana, bhakti. So bhakti and tyaga, ye do cheez bahut bahut important in life. If you want to get something, you have to leave something, that's for sure. And second thing, that unless otherwise you have a deep dedication towards whatever you want to achieve, you will never reach in your goal. So when I started my dance career with my mother. As everybody knows, she was a music teacher in a school. And she also, for a time being, she has learned with Guruji, Padma Vibhushan Guru Sri Kavicharan Mahapatra. And that was a link. So I started with her and continued my dance career with other gurus in different schools. And then I reached Guruji when I was age of 19. So till then, I was not being sure that I will be a professional dancer, because I was dancing, I was studying, and I was also a best a candidate for rifle shooting, NCC, so, you know, like sports and all that. Yes.
Wow.
So I have that dimension also is there. So actually that helps me to make my mental strength very strong, because, you know, like strong personality works in everything, and that works. And if you are a dancer, then definitely many hurdles will come, because it's a tough life. But to keep yourself very steady and always having a positive mind, that's so important. Because if you do not have the positivity, you cannot generate this. You have to generate this, because this is a vidya. This is Ma Saraswati. That's why we say, whenever you give art, it makes everybody enrich.
Yes.
And when you get Lakshmi, you enrich yourself. That is the two difference between Lakshmi and Saraswati. So as much as you share, your vidya will be more and more. So when I came to Guruji, and first day of learning, I could understand his ability and his way of teaching and his generosity made me feel for a moment that he is the perfect person. He's the perfect guru who can make me a dancer if he want to make my dance career. So until then, I was never thinking that I was loving dance. I will be keep dancing, but I was not very sure that dance will be my life. So because I was having many channel, like as I said, you know, like NCC, study and all that. So I wanted to become a police officer rather. And eventually it didn't happen, but the mentality of a police officer, which has two things, which is very much determined and strong mind, and second is discipline. Yeah. So these two things which really helped me in dance to make my art more stronger. And by God's grace, you need to have a good guru in your life, a mentor who can lead you a correct path. Because there are many dancers who are very talented, but if they do not get a good guide, then their talent will be worst. And it will be wasted. You know, like that way, I am also lucky that getting Guruji in my life and getting a family like Guruji's family in my life, which made me that dance is your everything. Mm-hmm. And this becomes your sadhana. Because if you love something and if you get that chance to enhance that and you get a great mentor who can make you disciplined to learn everything. So everything follows in one path. So that makes you very spiritual and makes you the journey very smooth. And of course, as you told me, that you tell Sujata Appa that sadhana is not an easier path. That everybody understands. Because those who are dancers, those who are artists, they know what is the difficulties they face. But other than artists, they should also understand this is not a normal life. This is something extraordinary life. Anything extra you do in your life, you have to give your effort a lot. So that way it is. If you want to get
your entire career graph starts from you being a shooter. And you have been an NCC cadet, then you want to become a police officer. I mean, how contrasting can it be? You know, I mean, if the police officer has to stand so straight with the back so straight, and when you dance, your entire posture is so, you know, it's moving like the leaves. It's so beautiful, so graceful. The entire body, even with the hand movement, is when you're doing march pass, your hand is straight like this. And when you're dancing, your hand is like, my God, what? I can't even, I mean, I'm trying to give of body posture. I'm just trying to imagine you would have been doing left.
but you know Durga, like, you know, that posture, that standing posture of a police person, actually that helps to make a dancer to, you know, represent herself as a dancer. When we start something, if our back is like this, like a hunchback, and actually, the discipline of a police officer is to make yourself very always alert.
Yes.
And that is a basic principle of a dancer also, which you can link that.
Right.
Keeping the structure strong and the mobility, the movement of the body should be soft. Because our dance is the mixture of Tandava and Lasya.
Wow.
Wow. So when the principle of Tandava and Lasya is there, you be strong. But Lasya will make the movement so graceful that it will represent Odissi. Because Odissi is a sculpturist dance and it's a so graceful dance. So everything comes when your sketch is ready. You can make it mobility in your directions.
It is amazing. I mean, that's the first classical dance form I fell in love with, thanks to Guruji.
Yes.
Guru Kelucharan Mahapatra ji stayed with us for 3-4 months when my mother was producing this Geet Govind as a dance ballet, and it was made at a huge scale. And Guruji stayed with us, and I got to experience the person first. What a person he was. My God.
Yeah.
I, in my entire life, never call anybody else Guruji other than my father, except Guru Kelucharan Mahapatraji. I cannot call him anything. I just call him Guruji. There's nobody else I call Guruji. Because he just, you know, that respect just comes from within. You know, it just comes, that emotions come from within. There is only respect and there's only love. There is no other third emotion, for him. It's so much of love and abundance. Ma, ma, ma. He will call everybody ma. He'll give kisses. He'll blow. I was very, very fortunate, truly, to have experienced that side of him, and of course to watch him perform, which, you know, later on, it was incredible. And that entire experience was so rich because the music was composed by my father.
Yeah.
He was choreographing, and Madhvi ji was Krishna, Madhvi Mudgal ji.
Yes, yes.
And the whole, every day the rehearsals would happen in my grandfather Vishantram studios.
It's such a great link and great love between two astros.
To actually, that was my experience. But here people have been, and Adrija also has mentioned that your first experience of meeting Guruji is very interesting. Please ask her to tell. A lot of people have said, please ask her, how did she meet Guruji?
I met Guruji in Odissi Research Center.
Hmm.
And, when he see a student, he actually reads completely. So when I came and I first bowed down, and then he just looked at me and then he said, where are you from? Then I said, I'm from Balasar. So he smiled and he said, Balasar peoples are not good. I was like, not good, not good. So I said, maybe some reason why, he said, because he never says anyone bad. As you said, no, he's always so much a person who loves the entire world.
Yes.
Yeah. So that's why everybody's respect comes from their heart. And I understand in this Indian classical dance, music, everyone has so much respect to Guruji. So when he said that, that was my first meeting, and he said like this, then I was inside thinking, that why Guruji said me like this, must have some bitter experience with him happened, so that's why he immediately said. So then after that chapter was over, and then he came to class and all that. When he comes to the class, you will not understand. He looks like, he is a man who is so soft in his heart, but when he comes to the class, everybody gets so scared because his teaching method is so strong and very, very pinned to the point.
Precise.
So, yeah, very precise. And he came to the first class.
Yeah.
He made us dance. Like after 10 minutes, we full drained, like full of sweat and all that. Like one step repeatedly, like 50 times, 70 times, 100 times. And I was like thinking, he doesn't look like that, strong, but he makes the students like this. If he will make like this, definitely we will be definitely good dancer for sure. Then the second day, but one thing I noticed, that he makes us dance for our betterment. The same time, he understand who has the skill of getting one step forward. So when I was sitting in Tribhangi, so he came backside, and then he just, I was sitting like a little, not too much curve, but just sitting Tribhangi. Tribhangi is like three bend, and one bend from knee point, and second bend from torso, and third from neck point. So I was doing overall, but he came and my torso was not perfectly bent. He just touched and pushed. That touch and push from the back of my shoulder and down to that. And then in that moment, it was like an electric shock for me. And I said, what he did, automatically my body went like this. Then I just felt in my mind, no, I want to be a dancer and in his hand. And he is the perfect man who can mold me as a dancer.
Wow.
So that was a moment. My respect from my heart as a guru for him was immediately reacted. So then after that, I become very sincere, and whatever he wanted to say, I keep on doing. And he also was every time testing each student. He will give a task to every student, and after 10 days, he will come back from his tour, abroad tour and all that. He will come back and he will exactly remember what he has given the task to us. And he is a tough taskmaster, and he has the real eyes to understand the skill of a student, and he can read the student emotionally and also physically what is needed. So all that thing, you know, like when I experienced with him day by day, my relation with him become very closer and very respectful and very dear. And that made me to understand him very closely. And he felt that I am sincere, and whatever he wants to say, I really obey that, and sincerely I do the practice, I do the homework, and I show him. So as a teacher, when a sincere student does the best, then the teacher get attracted, and teacher has the blessings for that student. And I think I'm one of them, that luckiest student to have Guruji in my life, to understand from the beginning. But the day one he said that the Balasar people are not good, but that was the thing kept always in my mind, that okay, he has a bitter experience, that's why he is saying, because after some days I understood why he said this and that. But I felt from inside he must be having a bitter experience, but I will make it sweeter, because
wow.
Five fingers are not the same, and I can be one of the fingers which can be a strong finger to show that all are not same, and I am the one person who can also give you better experience where you will forget your bitter experience.
Very nice, very sweet, very determined, very positive and very determined process, and it's very inspiring actually. It's very, very inspiring. And I like the fact that when he just did this and your whole move, that whole, you know, there must be some blessings also which just, you know, made your mind
that,
just
absorb
it. That touch must have happened with full of blessings, and it just changed that your mind from becoming a police officer to becoming a whole dancer. I will never get over this. I mean, being a shooter, okay, it can, you know, it can help your mind becoming more focused. But a police officer, wow, it's quite a journey.
Durga, that strong mentality helped me throughout my journey. You know, because there are ups and downs in the life happens.
Yes.
But because that strong mentality that and focus to do whatever I want to reach the goal. If dance is my destiny, made by God, Guru is my way, why not I avail all this?
Very nice. Very nice. So I had few questions about your dance, but I think before that we should see your first performance.
Huh? Yes.
So let's see your first performance and then we continue this dialogue. So,
yeah, I would like to just describe a little bit about the first performance, because it's a Pallavi and I have done the Pallavi choreographed by Padma Vibhushan Kelucharan Mahapatra and the music composed by Pandit Bhubaneshwar Misra. And the Pallavi name is Basant Pallavi. I know that everybody will be thinking, why Sujata Appa has done such a basic Pallavi? But I always feel that we are all rooted and we are not all the time dancing for the viewer, those who have learned or the seniors. There are, see, like Adrija, they're the beginners, they want to see. So if they see that I will be dancing Namami, I will be dancing, but to the very, very first step of the items, what we learned when we learn dance, they get more motivated and they get more inspired. So that's why I chose this Pallavi to dance today. Thank you.
Oh, beautiful. Thank you for explaining this. And Utsa Parivar, this is going to be a show where we watch her perform and then we start with the, we will start conversing with her for better understanding. So you can watch calmly, put down your questions after that. Then I'll take some of your questions. Then again, we will see her perform. So it is going to be like this. When I said today, the format is a little different today. It is only because an artist like her, when she comes, we change everything just to make her comfortable. So here we go. So can we have her first performance? Pallavi. Shashank is saying, I like this performance better, this format better. Uspe wo aaya hai.
Yeah.
Unbelievable, unbelievable. Like you said, this was simple. You said this is basic.
Because normally, Durga, everyone has seen me dancing Kiruvani Pallavi, Hamshadhwani. My favorite Pallavi is Hamshadhwani, Kiruvani, Behag, all Sankaravarana. So these are like the bigger Pallavis, which is 15 minutes, which is the duration is 16 minutes like that. So this is a Pallavi which is 7 minutes. That's why considering as other Pallavi, it's like the half of the Pallavi. But this is the basic and beautiful Pallavi. I really love it. And you know, like when you dance, being ideal for everyone, when you dance Basant Pallavi, everybody will understand the perfection happens even if you do 1 minute, even if the entrance of the stage, if you do not have the perfection, you dance for 20 minutes, it doesn't make any sense. It will never impact anyone. So, you know, all the bhangis, all the movements has been used. That's so beautiful. And Basant Raga, you know, as a musician, as a singer, you know how beautiful. As spring is beautiful in our life, same thing, Basanta Pallavi impacts a lot. So that's why I chose maybe small Pallavi, but very impact, very much impressive Pallavi. I love it.
I just wanted to say that you said this is basic, but the way you have performed it, it will take a lifetime to achieve that grace, that perfection. I want you to tell people what does bhangi mean, because I understand this terminology, bhangi, chalk. So if you can explain it to people who may be new to DC today, who may be watching. But to achieve that and that grace, you brought me to tears. You just moved me so much. Every posture, every movement, every second that you were moving from one posture to another, it was literally like as if you could see the people wrote poetry in motion. People wrote many things. Like I felt like there was, you know, there was beautiful wind in the leaves and the movement was so soft. Oof, it's too much. In that 7 minutes, it is work of 7 lifetime.
No, that's true. Actually, you know, the Guruji's choreography also
beautiful.
It's so rich, so beautiful. So if you are a strong dancer, if you are a beautiful dancer, so you can portray as you said, you know, like the poetry in motion. So, because Guruji's all creation is like a chain. One finisher, the finishing point and the starting point is so nicely, so smoothly is joined. So, it looks like a flow. It's not a cut. It's never jerky movements. It's all blend. As we know, the Pallavi is a graceful movement of not only the body, but also it is the combination of your head, neck, hand, mudras, bhangis, the feet positions, the feet movements. So everything, top to bottom, all is engaged. So,
and your eyes, madam, your eyes. Oh my God.
So all depends on the dancer and the choreographer and the music composer. It's yes. A blend of everything. Then only you can portray. And a part of all that, perfection is needed. Even if you do a bhangi, see, the keeping the Mayura Mudra, I can keep it like here. The same bhangi can look bad. If I know the proportionate keeping of the bhangi, where to keep the bhangi, then it will look. And when we do the movement, the wrist movement, particular the wrist movement, that wrist movement has the beautiful way of, now 1, 2, 3, when we do, we approach, we hold, we make our movements, the wrist movements plays a biggest role, and the torso makes us to move from one body movement to another body movement. The transition of the movement has to be very flawless. Then only it will look beautiful and it will look very graceful.
As
you said, Durga, just to mention that some people are asking, you know, like we have four bhangis in our Odissi, the basic bhangis. One is called Samabhanga, Abhanga, Tribhanga, and Choka. Samabhanga is standing straight. Abhanga is like Ardha Bhanga, half bend of the body. If I want to just stand, just a second. So these are the four stands in Odissi we do have, and our entire dance depend on this structure, because for this structure you have to spend a lot of time, lot of basic trainings. Because nowadays what happens, the basic training, they don't spend much time. They try to move on. But dance is not like moving on or something. It's like you have to make your foundation very strong. Then whatever you do, it will be really nice. And you can justice to the dance, and each bhangi will be, the clarity of the bhangi only will happen if you have a mastery and understanding and control over your body. Otherwise, it is difficult. Like for you, you know, like for Sur and all that, if that the steady Sur is not there, whatever you sing, it will look like unsteady.
Right.
Similarly, we do have all these basic stance, basic steppings and all that. If we do it regularly, if we do it nicely, our foundation is nice, then we build any kind of house, it will be very steady.
Very true. Very true. Very well explained and beautifully. There is Prarthana Patil here who's written, Basan the flowering, as Appa explained, that she chose this Pallavi for the younger generation to understand the basic Odissi. And I feel after learning this Pallavi, even the dancer's process starts to bloom as a dancer. Pranam, Sujata Appa. She's messaged you. I thought it was a very sweet message. I felt like reading out to you. Then Kidambi Jayashree said, will fall in love with you. Kidambi Jayashree said, will fall in love with her forever. I said, so sweet. But so the way you're explaining the four important parts of on which the foundation of Odissi dance is. And so when you talk about those, and the other very, very, very strong component of dance is Abhinaya.
Yes.
And today when I saw, of course, I was so emotional when you were doing everything. But when I saw you stand like Ram, I was only looking at your eyes and I kept crying like howling. I said, you know, you don't need to look at anything else. The Ram is in her eyes. She is not looking like a woman anymore. She looks like She's Ram. And you know, I said, she, look at the face. There was, and honestly, because I did a little bit of acting, I know you did not do anything very strong. Like, there was nothing.
No.
And that entire, I didn't know how you internalized that whole emotion. That was, it was like, I saw that one thing at least 50 times, rewind, and I said, see how in a second she's become Ram. And
actually, I really love the character of Rama. I don't know why, but as to portray the character of Rama in Ramayana, I have been dancing so many times, and especially with Guruji. Guruji used to be the Kevat, and I used to be Rama. So how to stand and how to be that in emotion? Because Rama is a character, it's a Veera Rasa. Completely calm, but with having that braveness. So it's a combination of both. So to portray that, it's not an easy. But for a female artist, when you feel that you love a character, you want to portray that, and you are guided by somebody who has made you as a Rama, that is Guruji. So all credit goes to him, because being dancing with him as a co-character. Yeah, co-character. Because when he was Kevat and he takes the Rama's feet and keeps it on his head, and holding that feet, and the emotion of looking at Rama. And I, you know, like I am too, as a disciple and a daughter-in-law of the house, and doing Rama's role, co-character of a strong personality like Guruji, doing the character of Kevat, and who takes your feet on his head. You know, like from my inside, the heart was like completely was shaking. But then he made that heart to be strong, steady. And he just explained me, here I am your devotee and you are my almighty. So when you are in that character, you are always a giver. And I am, as a devotee, has to take your blessings. So just reverse my character to you and your character to me. When a disciple wants the blessings from a guru, so she's completely surrender. And when a guru gives the blessings with full of, you know, like that calmness, that beautiful heart giving through the blessings, the love and care for the student. So you have to kind of be that. So dancing in that drama, and especially in this Abhinaya. You know, Abhinaya is like a transmission of expressions through your body. In Rama, you have to hold the bow, that dhanu, that's all. But the standing posture, the standing point, and how you feel from inside, because that godly feeling, but at the same time, you are a brave Nayaka. One time in NCPA, National Center of Performing Arts in Mumbai, they given me a task to perform the series of Nayaka. So I, Nayaka. So Guruji, I asked Guruji, so please tell me what to do. And it's a 1 hour show and I have to do something 45 minutes completely on Nayaka. So which character I should do? So Guruji just immediately said, why you are thinking, you have done Ramayana, Rama character all the time. Why don't you portray? And that is the best Nayaka. What else Nayaka? You will think of Ravana. You will think of something else. Why? You can think of Rama. Because that calmness, that the Nayaka who has that ability. So you can portray that. So by his blessings, I actually learned the Ramayana as a solo and performed many places. But here the Abhinaya, what I did, I did the Abhinaya that is choreographed by Ratikant Mahapatra, my husband, who has choreographed. And it's a very favorite song that Sri Ramachandra Kripalu Bhajamana. Yeah. Here, I just took one stanza because of the time constraint. And I showed how he is considered as Bira Nayaka. Because there are so many demons and all that. Because one question came to me that, you know, one person asked me, why Sujata, you wanted to perform Rama, why not Krishna? Krishna also is a Nayaka. I said, Krishna is a Sringara Nayaka. And where Rama is a Bira Nayaka. Oh, you know, that way I wanted to show the Veera Rasa with having Ramachandra. He has killed Ravana, he has killed so many demons, so many brave demons. So for me, I consider Rama. So here in the episode, I have just explained about the Dhanu Bhanga, how in the Sita Swayamvar, everybody is present. And they have been given the task of taking the Siva Dhanu and holding and breaking the Siva Dhanu. And how all the kings, they have done. And when Ramachandra comes, and very easily how he takes the Siva Dhanu. So that shows his braveness, his Veera Rasa. And so that's why I took in this Abhinaya. And then second with the Ravana, the fighting with Ravana. That two episode I had taken. But this is choreographed by Ratikant Mahapatra. And music composed by Pradeep Das. And the song is so favorite and so popular to everyone. Everybody knows.
And it's written by Tulsidas Ji.
Yes, that's a great. Yes, written by Tulsidas Ji.
So should we see your second performance now? So it's so beautifully described by you. So looking forward, can't wait. So let's hope and pray to God it all goes off well.
Yes.
Harana bhava bhaya daru nam. जब आए नर नारी नसुर सुकृत मनाए गुरही प्रणाम मन ही मन की
अद्भुत अद्भुत. आई मीन आई जस्ट कांट गेट ओवर दिस परफॉर्मेंस. हाउ यू आर बिकमिंग द राम, सीता, रावण. ओ माय गॉड, इट्स इनक्रेडिबल. इट्स सच अ डिवाइन एक्सपीरियंस जस्ट वॉचिंग यू.
It's a beautiful choreography of Guru Sri Ratikanth Mahapatra, because he after Guruji, like, he has made so many compositions, but this is one of the composition this is one of my favorite also. He has done Barsha, also about the monsoon, and Shavari, again that is also from Ramayana, and this is also Tulasidas Ramayana. So these are the composition what he, and the Pallavis also he made, but as an Abhinaya, all this is also his masterpiece. I really love to do that, to enact that, because when you are with a maestro like Guruji, he's such a perfectionist, and you know, after that, if somebody does a choreography, if you don't match with that, you know, chemistry and all that, then it will not make you enhance as an artist.
Yes.
So that way, he also, his knowledge of choreography as a group composition, as solo, he also has that mastery. So for a dancer to dance in that choreography, it's also a great feeling.
It's beautiful, and I would like to, you know, sincerely thank you know, Ratikanji also for this incredible contribution. He's yes. continued to keep the legacy of his great father and taken it ahead to the next generation. And you being besides him, all his dreams he can visualize.
And
I have seen him also perform. He's such a great dancer himself. I've seen him perform too. Yeah. So it's so wonderful. Many people want to know because they saw you watching yourself. So one person asked, I think somebody asked that, how was it what you when you're watching yourself as Ram, what are you thinking? And some, so they want to, another question is, what do you, when you see yourself performing, how do you like it? So what are you thinking when you see? So they are two almost the same, but one is Ram and one is
First of all, I want to say that, you know, like I never see myself performance, and this is an opportunity to see. And the other way also, because I don't know about the technology, so I can hide myself and watch also. That also I don't know, but somehow that's how you could see me. And it's nice experience that when I see, I can, as a teacher, I understand what mistake I have done. And as a viewer, I understand why people like you. And as you said that when you are portraying a character of Rama, I always dance, everybody sees me. I never see myself. So when I see myself, I do two things. One is I correct myself by watching myself. Second thing, I feel, yes, the character suits on me. Why people love me? What is the inner beauty in my dance? Sorry. Why they like? So when I'm standing in Rama position, it's not because that I'm just holding my body posture like that. No, I feel that Rama character from inside. So that I could visualize when I watch myself. So that is something. And of course, I feel good to see myself, because when now Guruji is not there to look at me, I can look myself in Guruji's eyes to correct myself, to make it more perfect, so that I can reach whatever Guruji wanted me to be, a dancer.
You know, when you see, when I see you dance, there are other aspects to your there are other aspects to your physicality, which actually make me feel that, you know, you were destined to be a dancer. You have such beautiful long arms. You are so tall and nice, so proportionate. You know, they help you to reach out to your audience even better. I am such a butler, so small.
Now, actually, you know, when I am seeing my daughter Pritisha right now, so when she has that, and she's slim because she's young, and when I look at her, I think, yes, why everybody gets attracted when you have a beautiful figure and perfect to dance? And what style of dance?
Perfect to dance.
Because we are Odissi dance.
A model's figure will not look good for
dance. No, not at all. Because our dance is a sculpturist dance.
Yes.
So you have to have your figure like a sculpture, where you can stand in a bhangi, it will look proportionate and it will look attractive. Correct. So nowadays, when I am seeing my daughter, I think of my young age. I used to be look like, because when she comes on stage, everybody saying, Sujata Appa, she's the replica of you. So I said, she's more beautiful. Why is everybody saying replica? Maybe in my young age, I was also having that thin and that kind of figure. So yes, you need to maintain a figure like this to, which will give you more plus point.
Yes.
Because it's a visual art.
Yes.
If you do not maintain your body, that is one of the instruments you have to make it tuned every day.
Wow. So do you do anything other than dancing to keep your body tuned?
Yes. I do yoga. I do meditation. And, you know, dance is not only physical. Dance also is mental.
Yes.
You can be fit physically, you can diet, you can be slimmer. Nowadays, many medicines comes, you know, within 5 days, you can be very slim. You know, you can do like this, but it's not like that. That positivity in your mind, when you do meditation, when you do puja, it directly connects to, if I do a Rama character, but inside my soul will be craving as a nature of Ravana, I cannot portray that character. It has to be totally divine.
Yeah.
So, you know, like that's why the yoga, meditation, all that helps you to keep mentally fit. And because I do puja, it helps me to connect to the divine power, connect to the divinity of the dance. What is the spirituality of the dance, you know, ultimately dance is an offering and we offer through the dance to the Almighty. And we portray the character of Krishna, Radha, Rama, Sita, all that character. We also portray Ravana character, but that is evil character. The negative character we have to portray, because how to make the divine character supreme power. Because they have done so many things, achiever. So they have demolished all the demonic powers. So that's why they are divine. So to connect that divine power, definitely you need to have that spirituality in your mind, which is our root of the dance form.
It's beautiful, beautiful. What you have said is, you know, finally, the goal of our art forms is to reach the Almighty God.
Yeah.
And, you know, if one is, you know, tuned, like you said, your body has to be tuned. Your mind also has to be tuned towards that focus. Because
otherwise it will look fake. Because why, when Guruji performs, you have seen Guruji perform so many times. When Guruji performs, why he takes you to a different level? Why people feel that stage becomes a temple? He doesn't make any decorate, or he doesn't bring any props to make it temple. But his inner energy is so divine. It makes the entire energy of the stage divine and makes it the atmosphere of a temple.
True.
by looking at that aura, we get to learn many things. Because I remember I have done a group choreography called Adyanta. Adi and Anta. Adi, the starting, Anta is the ending. So Adyanta. So what is our Adi? What is our beginning? Beginning, we are like a, we are taking the birth, the yes. baby, and childhood, our youth, and then the experience of our life and death. So in dance, we have that same journey. When we do Mangalacharan, we invoke the aura of auspiciousness. We offer our salutation to Lord Jagannath, who is our main deity. So the Mangalacharan becomes our birth. And childhood becomes our Battu. Battu is a pure dance, which is the first technical piece in dance, which is our childhood when we go to study, from home when we go to study to the school. That is the first study we learn from the schooling.
Wow.
So same thing, if we, you know, we actually from a childhood and we connect to our Battu. And then when it youth, in youth, you are like completely in a different aura. Same thing in Pallavi. Because in Pallavi, there, if you start seeing a tree, how the tree grows with the branches, the flowers, the leaves, the everything, it makes you beautiful. Same thing in the youth. You become little matured and you become...
You blossom.
You blossom. Yeah, you blossom. Exactly. Pallavi is like blossoming. And then experience, when you get married and you have an experience of life, that is called Abhinaya. We don't do Abhinaya on stage just like this. The Abhinaya, actually the life experience is become so much Abhinaya. You have to act as a mother. You have to act as a wife. You have to act as a daughter-in-law. You have to act as whatever your profession is. And you have to act as a woman. Sir, there are so many things.
Yes.
So that is the real life, which is Abhinaya, that we are actor and actress in this life which God has given us the birth. And we are acting, same thing we are doing on stage. It's so much linked and connected to our life journey and this journey and death. And we do moksha, moksha for the salvation. When we, in life, normal life, we approach to death, we also completely get the salvation, moksha from God. Same thing, we surrender completely to ourselves, to the Almighty, that save us, we are finishing our dance repertoire. Yeah, wow. It's very much linked and connected. Wow. So we are always connected with this, and this is how we learn each step of our life so formally. And it is never detached from our life. It is always attached.
You know, I'm sure a lot of people have told you, but you have reached a state in your life, in spirituality, and along with your dance, that in every little thing you are seeing dance. In everything that you probably look at an aeroplane also and you will see dance. You've reached that kind of a level, that state, evolved state as an artist. And that is the ultimate stage of any artist.
Yeah.
To reach, one can aspire that, you know, okay, I want to become a great artist. But what is a great artist? Finally, the great artist is not somebody who's only sitting on the stage and singing for the audience.
Yes.
When in everything in life that you see, be it a car in motion, whether it is a phone ringing, or whether it is a plane, or whether it is a glass of water, everything just becomes that art for you.
Yes.
And you're looking at it in that way and you feel that it is, now I have got something.
Yes.
So I really feel when listening to you, when how beautifully you said from Adi to Ant, Adi, yes. Ant. Is you are seeing life only in dance in motion.
Yes. However you look at it, because, you know, like it's like an inseparable coin.
Yeah.
So in the coin, one part is there, the other part is not there, then you are, it is not a complete. And if you want to be a dancer, if dance will be your breathe, dance will be your dream, dance will be your sleeping, awaking, everything, then only, however you do, it will look like a dance.
You have awakened. You have an enlightened soul with your art. You have the blessings of your guru. You have your life partner who is a guru also. And yes, you yourself, with your own dedication, you have reached a level where you are inspiring. You are enlightening this world with your art. And the purpose of your life is to just live this dance form. And you're doing this every moment. I can, you know, while you're talking, for me, that is also dance. You know, I am feeling my soul is so fulfilled and so overwhelmed right now that I want to be in this state of mind for some time. Really, I don't want to lose this. I'm getting goosebumps listening to you, seriously. And I am so feeling so happy. Meeting you is, of course, it's so such a privilege to meet you. And I feel extremely happy to meet you because you are the daughter-in-law, I would say daughter of our most beloved, most revered Guru Kelucharan, yes, Mahapatra. There's nobody like him. Yes. And he is immortal because he has you. So, you know, and of course, many other students, but you are special. You are very, very special. And somebody whom he loved, somebody whom he blessed from his heart.
Very so, rightly you said that, you know, I am not, I also never think him in father-in-law. I always mentioned that he was my father. That's yeah. why I forgot my father. I never even wanted to go to my parents' house when he was alive. And he was all the time, that fatherly love, guidance, everything. So never in-law. So I rightly said that I am daughter of Kirchana yeah. Mahapatra.
And I'm still getting goosebumps. Is that goosebump is not stopping. But thank you, Sujata ji. So lovely to meet, talk to you. Last time I met you in Dhaka, it was such a beautiful evening. And that yeah. night, I can never forget. And we had a crazy conversation. We were just laughing. I remember even Ram Kumar Mishra ji was there. And we were just three of us laughing. But today, I'm feeling very, very overwhelmed. I'm spiritually elevated with your dance, with your thoughts, with your what you've spoken, what you have shared with us. Has enriched my life beyond imagination.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And my pranam to Panditji.
Yes.
And you won't believe, my first award in dance was Pandit Jasraj Award. I will never forget. I will never forget you in your papa's name. It's such a great blessing, you know, like to enhance my dance career. That was my first award. So I do my pranam to him, and from our family, our gratitude to your family, and especially to you who is carrying the legacy. And we all are in the same path, and we are always together, and our art is always great.
Thank you so much. I love you. I love you. I love you. Want to give a big hug and bless
Thank
me.
You.
Thank you so much. And my pranams to Ratikanji also. And yes. best wishes to your daughter. I'm looking forward to her performance very soon. Really.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you
so much.
Thank you.
Bye.
And, oh my God, Utsah Parivar, please come for tomorrow. Tomorrow we have a supremely talented maestro, great maestro of tabla from London. He is logging in, the great Sanju Sahai. He will be performing for us, so don't forget. It's going to be mesmerizing evening, I can assure you. And I hope and pray to God everything goes off fine. But for today, thank you. I don't want to say much. I want to be left alone with this, really, this spiritually evolved state of mind. I'm just feeling so divine from within. I'm so blissful. I just want to be like this bye bye, I love you, I love you, I love you, big hug, bye bye, jai ho.